My whole life, I realized that art was something I was truly passionate about. And by the beginning of my senior year in high school, I was determined to make my passion into my career. As I started looking into colleges and the requirements needed to apply, I realized I was missing a huge aspect: a portfolio. Without an art teacher, I was nowhere near ready to apply, and I found myself going upstream without a paddle. So I'm here today to make sure that anyone who wants to make their passion for art their career will be prepared to apply to an art school. I gathered information from students, teachers, and the admissions office at Massachusetts College of Art and Design to come up with some tips that may be useful to future artists. First, I interviewed Helen Zuckerberg, the Associate Director of Mass Art, and I asked her what a portfolio actually was.
A portfolio is actually the strongest, most recent work that someone has made. It's not a fancy box full of things. It's not pictures that are framed. Portfolio is your work, and you're constantly building a portfolio over the course of the time you're making work, so it always changes. In terms of art school, a portfolio is usually the strongest work that you've made in the past couple of years. Every school, every art school has a different way they tweak what they want to see in terms of what that portfolio should be. But what all art schools want to see is drawings from direct observation. That's drawings made from life.
Drawings from direct observation may be one of the most difficult parts of creating a portfolio for any artist. However, it is extremely important. These drawings show colleges that an artist has an understanding of space, shadow, and depth when looking at a real-life object. Artists can draw anything they see in front of them, ranging from people to the corner of their room. However, it is important to remember, copying from a photograph or something that you see online is not drawing from direct observation. Even though drawing from direct observation is required in your portfolio, it is still important to remain true to your personal artistic point of view. Next, I asked Helen what an art school is looking for when they review an artist's portfolio.
Different art schools will give you different kinds of assignments. They're all geared towards trying to figure out how well you see, how long you've been drawing, what kind of ideas you have. But in terms of preparing a portfolio, practice is everything.
For students who do not have an art teacher, practice becomes even more important. These students are required to think outside of the box to find different ways to learn the skills others may be gaining during the school hours. Most of the time, this problem can be solved by looking in your community. Checking local colleges for studio art courses or summer programs may be the easiest option. However, you may be able to find local artists that offer free classes. If all else fails and you don't have a library card, YouTube can be a man's best friend. Next, I asked Helen what an artist should do if they don't have an art teacher.
Practice. Draw, draw, draw. If there are art classes available at a community college, try to take that. If there are art classes available at an art school, so for example, if you lived within driving distance, a half an hour, let's say, to Mass Art, you could take classes at Saturday Studios. We have portfolio classes. We have life drawing classes for juniors and seniors. We have summer programs.
Another big question artists have is what else should they be putting into their portfolios? Choosing which pieces to use can be hard, but it is important to make sure you have as many pieces as possible to select from. The biggest suggestion any artist who has applied to an art school can give is to draw several different pieces in many styles and mediums to find what you feel is your best work. Finding multiple inspirations can be helpful in sparking creativity. Another suggestion for students without an art teacher would be to use every opportunity possible to turn a school project into an art assignment. This will help you form skills around deadlines and make you think outside of the box. Next, I asked Helen, what else should we put into a portfolio?
It's your strongest work. It can be drawing, it is sculpture, it could be photography, studio work is work where you make things. Some people love Legos. Some people love to do what are called collages, so you're taking pieces of things and putting them together in a different way. But drawing is always a very big part of anyone's portfolio for any art school. And if you don't have options for having art classes in your high school and you want to go to art school, you need to do this on your own, which makes preparing for art school that much more difficult than preparing to go to any other kind of school, because if it's not part of your curriculum, then your passion for what you want to do and where you want to go becomes that more apparent to the schools that you're applying to.
Going to a vocational tech high school, I don't have an art teacher, so it was very hard to try to learn the things I needed to put in my portfolio without having that, you know, extra person to help me out. But I did do a lot of things like go take some summer classes, and I did some local colleges that had courses, and then I asked, you know, different colleges online that have a Facebook page that'll post some assignments you can do, just to learn how to do things that I didn't, you know, well, I wasn't able to learn on my own.
For anyone who may be having trouble finding their flow, or maybe that key piece of inspiration, there are a couple tips to help you through these hard times. Doing groups of different pieces related to the same topic may help the creative juices, such as drawing an item in many different places. Another good tip is relating things that you enjoy to things that you may not. For example, if you struggle with direct observation, try drawing something you love, like a soccer ball or action figure. This will help you prevent procrastination on the pieces you may not want to do. And finally, always remember to take breaks. Even though it may seem hard, it is important to take breaks. Going back with fresh eyes will help you look at your pieces in a new light. Next, I asked Helen what tips and pointers she could give to artists to help them improve their skills.
Have a sketchbook, have it with you all the time. You can draw anything. You can draw your hands, your feet, yourself. You may have family members who fall asleep on the couch. They're not moving, so they're perfect people to try to draw because they're not going anywhere. Drawing animals, unless they're sleeping, is difficult, but you can make still lifes at home. You can draw your shoes. You can put a shirt on a hanger and put it on the wall and draw that. And just keep doing it and be aware that you have to be able to make changes to what you've already done. And the more you work, the more you draw, the better you're going to get. I mean, I'm a perfect example of somebody who learned how to draw by drawing. I came to Mass Art as an illustration major. I had extensive experience in photography. I had been taking drawing and painting classes from my prior school. I had a certain level of expertise, and I came here and I was completely blown away by my fellow students. And so I had a sketchbook and I rode the T, the subway. And that's my form of transportation. And I started drawing on the T, which forced me to work really fast. And I would draw, and the next day I would draw more, and the next day I would draw more. And by the end of the summer, I had a bunch of sketchbooks, which I didn't look at. But when I went to class, and I was in my first drawing class, I made drawings I didn't recognize because I had gotten that much better. So it is something that a person could be afraid of in the beginning, because we have these expectations in terms of how good we're supposed to be. But if you just keep at it, you're going to get that much better.
Applying to college is only one of the many stressful things that take place during a student's senior year in high school. It is important to keep your grades up as well as try and keep your stress level down. Some students have jobs or family issues that take up time in their daily lives, so it is never too early to start preparing to apply to college by contacting schools and looking to see what their requirements are by checking their webpage for more information. I asked a design and visual communication student at Bristol Plymouth Regional Technical Vocational High School if he felt he had enough time to create his portfolio.
I did, in fact, have plenty of time to create my portfolio. The issue was that I just didn't take advantage of that time. I had several months to do it, and I was just distracted with life issues and basic procrastination, which is unfortunate for my case, but I did end up finishing it.
Next, I asked Travers if he felt like he had enough time to meet the deadline requirements to apply to college.
No, I didn't have a whole lot of trouble. I did end up doing my whole portfolio in a week and ended up passing it in the night before. So there wasn't too much trouble because I got it in on time, but yeah.
I asked Helen what a completed portfolio should contain when it is done and ready to be sent.
15 to 20 pieces of original work, the strongest work completed within the past 2 years. Drawing from direct observation is required in your portfolio. You need 5 to 10 pieces. So there's a minimum of 5. Even if you know that you want to study photography, let's say, or film video, you still have to have drawing in your portfolio because in the first year you will be drawing. So there's 5 to 10 pieces, drawings made from direct observation, and then beyond that, whatever your strongest work is. So that could be anything.
It is always important to remember that your completed portfolio should be something that you are proud of. Next, I asked Helen how grades and SAT scores are weighted compared to your portfolio.
At MassArt, the portfolio is equal to your grades. In fact, if push came to shove, the portfolio would be secondary to your grades. A BFA program is very difficult. It requires a tremendous amount of time, effort, It's not a walk in the park. And we have a 3.0 grade point average requirement or higher. We do require SATs or ACTs, but those scores are relative to your GPA, your grade point average. So if you have a B average or higher, then your SAT scores, your ACT scores are not as important to us. If it's lower, if your GPA is lower than 3.0, then we are going to look more closely at your standardized test scores. We are going to pay attention to every single grade and every single class, and we will take things into account in terms of whether there's a certain subject that is one in which you have difficulty. And though you work hard, you don't score as high in that. We're going to pay particular attention to your English classes, and your social science classes, history classes, art classes.
I asked Helen if students without an art teacher have less of a chance of getting into an art college.
We will know, looking at your transcript or perhaps the essay that you write, that you don't have certain kinds of classes available to you, but the fact that you've looked outside of your school, perhaps for art classes at a local community college or at an art school, or maybe there are artists who have classes in their studios, or maybe you're even trying to work on your own. These are different ways for you to learn how to draw, how how to get better at it and get yourself to the point where you're ready to apply to art school.
I asked Travers what advice he could give to future artists and if he got into the college that he wanted to.
Don't procrastinate. If you want to get into a college, you gotta work hard to do it. Luckily for me, I don't know what happened, but through some great whoever's up there, I got into the college I wanted to. But basically, just do what you have to do on time because it's really important. And you don't want anything rushed. You want things to be looking the best they can so that you can go where you want to. I did get into the college that I wanted to. I got into Massachusetts College of Art and Design.
Even though creating a portfolio may seem impossible, I hope that these tips will help you in completing your quest of applying to college for a career in art. Just remember to always stay true to your own artistic point of view, never let anything get you down, and never ever procrastinate. My name is Carolyn Brum, and I'll be attending Massachusetts College of Art and Design, class of 2018. If I can do it, so can you.